All this week in my medical alert, I'm going to help you look and feel younger, thinner, and happier. Tonight, the key to weight loss and fitness success could be right in your pocket. People are finding that smartphone apps helped them get into shape. And they're combining that technology with simple weight loss tricks that you can do right now.
I've lost a lot of weight, a lot of body fat.
These days, Stacy Clover is a gym regular.
I love being in the gym and seeing the results.
This is Stacy at 265 pounds. She managed to keep off more than 100 pounds with a trainer. But when he isn't around, she stays on track with the MyFitnessPal app.
Makes me look back and see what I've eaten throughout the day.
Every diet works if you work it.
Nutritionist Gail Starr says dieting is a mindset.
Know what you're eating, when you're eating, and why you're eating it, and how you're eating it.
Here's her advice. Use small plates and small utensils to trick yourself. Eat slowly so your brain has time to realize you're getting full. Don't eat after 7 p.m. Drink water before every meal to fill you up. And there are also simple things you can do to get exercise.
It's parking your car farther away from where you're going. It's walking up a flight of steps instead of taking the elevator.
And there are apps to track all that work, like one called Get Running, Couch to 5K.
The first week, you run a mile, walk a mile. By week six, you're running.
Starr says only weigh yourself once a week at the same time on the same scale. Also get enough sleep because if you don't, you will eat more. And don't drink soda, diet or regular. There is more potentially good news for those who enjoy a glass of red wine. Scientists have found more evidence that a chemical in red wine could help prevent cell aging. But this only happens with very high levels of the chemical. One researcher says the amount given to mice in a study would be like a person drinking 100 glasses of red wine every day. Miracle drug or pure poison? The vaccine with storylines of success and horror.
I thought she was dying. I thought she was dying the way she was acting.
I'd be like really dizzy and kind of out of it.
And aggressive.
It kind of felt like a fog.
So I took her to the hospital.
How outraged parents are battling pharmaceutical giants while doctors defend the treatment. That's tonight after Revenge at 11. And long commutes may be doing more than just getting on your nerves. A new study suggests the long haul may be adding inches to your waistline. According to an article published in the American Journal of Preventive Magazine, people who have a long drive to work are more likely to be overweight. Doctors say drivers simply burn less calories because they're sitting longer. Makes sense. Previous studies have tied serious health risks like cardiovascular disease, cancer, and early death to time spent sitting. So doctors encourage workers to get moving by taking active breaks at work.